Episode 1063, Naughty or Nice.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy every day. Can you believe it? You have made it. It's Friday. And on top of that, it is Confession Day. You can raise the roof to a happy dance, to a spin around. You know what? This is going to be awesome. It's Confession Day. And with confession, you know, we get to let it all hang out. Naughty and nice. For those of you who are brand new to Creation Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Okay, I am on the naughty list, I think, not on the nice list. I have been a little busy lately. Guess what? Yes, your prayers have been answered. Okay, my prayers have been answered too. We have an eye on the house. And so we are in the process of actually putting an offer down. So if you'll be praying that if this is the house that we are now to be calling our home, that it will happen. So I'm very excited. But with that comes a little bit of the naughty part. You know, buying a new house is great. But the naughty part is, well, I'm kind of flying by the seat of my pants. I think sometimes Santa Claus flies by the seat of his pants. Well, I got to tell you, I'm running this totally edit-free, and we're going to see what happens in our little confessions. But I wanted to confess to you today is I actually don't have a lot planned for this episode. I didn't write a lot of notes, and sometimes I do and sometimes I don't. It just depends. But this is coming to you from the heart. Mom to mom, mom to dad. Whatever it is, wherever you are, we've got to think about naughty and nice because everyone wants everything, right? And it's 'tis the season for naughty and nice. We've got to get on that list. And I don't know about you, but I've kind of used that bribing technique, you know, dangling the little carrot in front of the horse to get them to come. Have you ever fallen into that trap where you bribe your kids to do something in order to get something so they can get something, but you get something in return too. Okay, maybe it works to some degree, but the problem is if we continue this, we set our kids up, in my opinion, for failure, meaning that then they just get whatever they want. They can manipulate their way. They know that if they act a certain way, then mama's going to want them to act a different way. So mama's going to say, well, if you do this, then I will give you this. Now, I want to take it back. I want you to think about the most perfect parent. I believe the most perfect parent would still bribe. But I think about the most perfect parent as Jesus Christ. And I think, oh, He doesn't bribe us, does he? God doesn't sit there and say, you know what? If you do this, my child, then I will give you this. But what do we do to him? We say, oh, Lord, right now, come on. If you do this for me, if you show up right here, right now, and give me this miracle, then I will whatever, whatever, whatever. How do you fill in the blank? Come on, it's confession day. We got to be honest. And this naughty and nice list that I think about, so often we just think about kids, but it happens to us as adults too. We do it to our spouses. We're like, you know what? I've got this honey to-do list and I've got these three things done and the family's coming. And sweetheart, if you could just do this, this, and this, then I will give you in return this, this, and this. We're guilty, aren't we? We are. Now, this is not about the guilt. This is about opening up the box and understanding within ourselves that this is actually occurring. I don't believe we mean to do it. I really don't. I think about Mary, Jesus's mother. When Jesus went and was in the temple, he wanted to learn. He wanted to learn about his God. And he just wanted to hear. And he couldn't get enough information fast enough. And here he runs off to the temple and he's hiding and Mary can't find him. Now, I don't think that conversation when she went to the temple and found him would have gone like this. Now, Jesus, I know you were wanting to study about your heavenly Father and you wanted to learn from the priest and hear their thoughts. but you're so young. But next time, if you want to go, that's fine. You need to ask me, and then I will make sure you do this. I don't think the conversation went that way. I think it was more like, you disobeyed me. I am your mother. And you are to follow the boundaries that I have set. Period. End of story. Now, we look at it as a naughty or nice list. Some might say, well, you know, I do bribe my kids. Is there anything wrong with that? There's not necessarily something wrong with it, but what we're doing is we're setting our kids up to fail. We're setting ourselves up as an individual to fail. Because what you're doing is you are investing your energy and time, your effort, that if they do this and follow through, you will give them this. But what if they fail and they don't do it and you don't give them that? Then how is that reflected back on you? Well, maybe we're back on the naughty list. This I know is a little deep for a Friday, but I couldn't help with this being the whole holiday season and Christmas about just leaving out this whole idea of the naughty and nice list and bribery. And I know it sounds weird, bribery, but that's ultimately what we're doing. But God doesn't bribe us. Instead, he leads with what? Grace, mercy. He disciplines us. He forgives us. He's grateful. All of which we should take note in. So my whole thing in looking at the naughty and nice, when you're trying to raise your kids, when you're trying to raise yourself, and I'm not saying raise as in grow your children up. I'm saying raise your children as in lift them up. Yes, we need to raise our children as in we need to discipline them. We need to help guide them. But we also need to take our children and we need to lift them up. Take them higher than what they expect of themselves. Because one person will only live up to the ceiling that is set for them. But if you raise a ceiling and they can get and they're starting out at the floor, they're going to go so much higher. But if you say, oh, no, this is my expectation, you're going to keep it at a lower level, then that's as far up as they will grow. We need to raise them up. It's not about naughty and nice. It's about learning. It's about forgiveness. It's about growing. And it's about doing what God wants us to do. And it's hard. I know. I get it. I think about it as the attitude of gratitude. We have to have a posture when it comes to how we speak to our children, how we want to raise them up. Because if we listen to the words that we say, most of the time, what? We're knocking them down. You didn't do this. So because you didn't do this, you're going to be grounded. Yes, I believe in discipline. And in some circumstances, that is correct. But in other circumstances, we can flip the coin and we can say, I recognize that you studied really hard for this test. And it's unfortunate that you got an F on it. So what's going to happen for the next test? What do we need to do and work together on? What can you do? What can I do to help you? Now, in that whole discussion, there's no, well, if you study harder, Sam, then you will get a better grade. And if you get a better grade, then I will give you $20. Okay, $20, that's awesome. Or I get an iTunes card or I get a new phone. You can bribe all you want, but it's not helping them achieve their goals. It's not helping them gain survival skills for when they grow older. We're not raising them up. We're actually tearing them down. Naughty and nice. So what is it that we need to do today? How can we remove ourselves from the naughty and nice? Instead, raise our children up. Here is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Train our children as God trains us. We've got to raise up our children and train our children as God trains us. And that is something that, well, it doesn't fall in the naughty or nice. It falls into the What do I do? What does that really look like? Because I'm used to criticizing, or I'm used to having this done another way because that's how I was raised. And we just repeat the cycle. At some point, we have to stop the cycle, and that starts with you. You have to stop a cycle to start a cycle. So do you want to continue hitting your child, not literally, I'm meaning this figuratively, but bombarding them with the words of, you can't do this. Why didn't you get this right the first time? I know I'm guilty. I have found myself saying, well, why didn't you study harder? Well, what if he really did study as hard as he could study? Why are you beating him up for that? Why are you making him feel worse than what he already does? We need to be building up, training our children as God trains us. What does that look like? Number one, love. We have to love them where they're at. Now, when they're littler, they're in a different season. Our love can be all of snuggles and cute things and fun things and being very consistent. But as they get older, that consistency has got to change. It just maybe rings louder because they're going to be older. They're going to have a different curiosity when it comes to their mindset and what they want to experience. You know, when you've got a little baby who's crawling on the floor, they can't reach the hot stove. But when you have a 4.5-year-old that's running around crazy yelling and screaming and you have a hot stove, you've got to teach them that this is hot. They couldn't reach it before, but they can now. So your consistency shifts with the season. So you have to love them where they're at. Number two, you have to give grace. It's all about grace. God gives us grace, and we get it every single day, and we so do not deserve it. I don't deserve it. I unfortunately maybe ignore my children at times. I get caught up in editing some of my programs or doing and writing work that I kind of blow them off. Not meanly, I just say, I'll be right there, and that I'll be right there ends up 2 hours or 3 hours later. That's not helping my child at all. And then when they get mad at me, I'm like, I told you I was coming, I'm here now. And they're like, but you were gone for like 3 hours, Mom. And then they start to get sassy, and then you do what? You get sassy right back. Does that help anything? Does that solve anything? It does not. It doesn't solve anything. So you have to give grace. You need grace, and in return, you need to give grace. We're all learning. This isn't a cut and dry, you know, here's your instruction manual as to how to live on earth and how to be the perfect parent and how to be the perfect child of God. It doesn't work that way. God knows we've fallen short, and we always will, but he still sets up boundaries. He still is consistent. We have to do the same with our children. Train our children as God trains us. Number one, love them where they're at. Number two, give grace. And number three, forgiveness. I can remember one of my discussions, many discussions with 5 children. You have lots of children discussions. And now, of course, my children are getting older and my expectations are different of them. Their expectations of me are different. You know, when you're a little child, you're just like, Mom, make me happy. Give me what I want. And then when they're older, they're like, I want freedom. Leave me alone. And you're like, oh, I cannot win for losing. No, you can't. You're learning this. So take a deep breath. You're going to get it. And you're going to take it one step at a time. But in doing that, you have to have forgiveness because you're not going to be right. And so this one time I can remember having this conversation with my daughter, and I was blown away because I was like, really? You knew this. This is like your second or third time. What is your issue? Why haven't you learned? What's your problem? And I would ask questions that were really just, you know, hit her at the core where she wasn't good enough. I might as well have told her that. You're not good enough. You keep making the same mistakes. You're not good enough. That's not what I was saying, though. That's not what I was trying to say. But that was her interpretation. Now, of course, I didn't think about it then at the time until we had another conversation in which I had to ask for forgiveness from her, and then I had to extend forgiveness. It goes both ways. But it takes us as the leader, you're the parent. You have to lead. And in leading, that means you have to forgive. And in that forgiveness, there's training. That doesn't mean discipline doesn't happen. Understand this. But we're talking about how does God train us so we can train our children? It's with love, with grace, and with forgiveness. And when you have all of that, that is a recipe for heavenly success. We can't control our children. We can't control their actions, but we can raise them up. We can train them up so that they will come back to what they know. Even when they drift, they'll still come back, knowing that you still love them, knowing that you will give them grace, knowing that your forgiveness is there. That doesn't mean you won't like what they've done or won't like what they may do in the future, but it's the right now. It's in the present. The problem is we get ourselves as parents stuck in this. If I don't do this right now, then 10 years from now, this could happen. Yes, we need to look at that, but we have to look at what's right now, because that's what the child sees, is what's right now. God looks at us the same way. He says, what's right now, my child? What is it? You know, Charlie Brown says this, what if today we were grateful for everything? The naughty or nice? What would happen, naughty or nice? Instead, just switching around and saying, you know what? What if I was just grateful for the good and the bad? That doesn't mean I have to like the bad, but I can accept it for what it is, and I can learn from it, and I can move forward. God does that for us. He says, I love you where you're at, my child. I extend you grace because, yeah, you kind of messed up, but yet I forgive you at the same time. Here's your second chance. Go out and live, love, and impact. Where are you sitting with your child's conversations? Are you bribing them? Are you trying to fit them on the naughty or nice list? Are you trying to say, hey, if you do this, then you're going to be a better teacher. You're going to be a better son. You're going to be a better athlete. You're going to be a better dancer. If you would just do this, you will have my heart forever. If you go and do this and you work hard with your grades, you can be number one in your class. You can be valedictorian. You can go on and you can graduate. You can go to the elite schools on a full ride scholarship. Then you will say you have made it. We've got to start listening to our conversations. Are we trying to set our children up for the naughty or nice? Because in this world, it's naughty and nice. We don't get to choose. We get it all because we're fallen. But God says, I can handle that. And so learn from me, he says. Learn from me. Love. Love them where they're at. Give grace and extend forgiveness. I know this is tough stuff. Being a parent is the most rewarding and crazy, chaotic, awesome responsibility that you can have. And it's a gift and it's a blessing. But it can also be a curse. I get it all. And some of us seems that we've got it easier and we don't need a lot of help. But for others, maybe you struggle. And guess what? You're not alone. This here is to not make you feel alone. It's here to comfort you and to help guide you. Maybe you need some help with that. You need someone to come beside you. I have a free gift for you. It doesn't matter if you're naughty or nice. It's a free gift. Because God says to extend that to you. It's a coaching call with me. Click on the link, take aim in the show notes. There you have the opportunity to have a coaching call with me. When you click on that link, a little form will come up. Fill out that basic information. That information comes directly to me. No one else sees it. And I will be in touch with you via email at first, and we will set up a time and schedule with you a time for you and I to have a coaching call. There's no charge to this at all. I'm not even going to try to sell you something. It's my gift to you. You're worth it. Your family's worth it. Your children are worth it. Your spouse is worth it. If you have the need or you want the help, regardless, you just want someone to talk to. You've had a situation. The holidays bring out, not always the best in us. They sometimes bring out more of the worst. I don't want you sitting down there late at night after wrapping presents and things have settled down and you're like, gosh, I might as well put myself on the naughty list. It's not about naughty or nice because we have both. You get to choose. I would love to walk beside you and help you with that. Now, going back to Charlie Brown, what if today we were grateful for everything? Does it matter the naughty or the nice? We accept it as both. And we learn from it. We grow from it. And we are raised up for it. You are a child of God. You are loved. Your spouse is a child of God. Your children each are a child of God's. So it's up to you to say, okay, you know what? I'm going to come with gratitude. And I'm going to understand and learn how God is teaching me. And I'm going to train my children as God trains me. You got this. You can do it. Because one step at a time leads to your miles of greatness. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.